going on, you guys? It's John here, and today what I'm going to do is walk you guys through this super cool and easy rock riff from Alice Cooper called "School's Out." The Coop. So let's get right into this. What's going to happen here is you're going to start this out with a low E chunk. I call it a chunk because it's not a totally open note. It's a palm muted note. Okay, so a real quick crash course in palm muting. Make sure that this is the palm that you're using to palm mute, okay? And your palm is halfway on the bridge and halfway on the strings, okay? Now you'll probably have to, if you're not familiar with this technique, you'll have to slide your hand up and down to see how much of the bridge and how much of the strings your hand needs to be on. But the sound that you should be getting is a kind of closed down sound rather than a totally open sound like that, okay? So you're gonna start out with two chunks, and then what you're gonna do is come over to the D string and the G string at the 14th fret. And I'm using my third finger for this. Some people use their first finger, either way. But you want two chunks, and then that little mini chord right there, that the D string and G string, 14th fret. Sounds like that, okay? And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go back to two chunks on the low E string, and then you're gonna go to the 12th fret at the D string and G string. Okay, so you've got this. I give it a little shake, a little wobble, it's called vibrato. You can do that. A little vibrato never hurt anybody. Right? Happens next is you're going to do two chunks again, okay, and then you're going to hit your chord at 14, which is 14 D string, 14 G string, okay, and then what you do is reach up next to the 12th fret on the G, and it's just one little note. You've got to put some vibrato on that, so wiggle that note a little bit, okay. That. Okay, let me link all that together so you can see how that sounds. Okay, now what comes next is this little pull-off riff, okay? Now if you're not familiar with pull-offs, basically what you're doing is let me show you where the notes are first. You're gonna start out on the D string, 14th fret, okay, with your third finger. And then what's gonna happen is you're gonna pull your finger down and away. It's kind of like you're flicking the string like this, okay? So you pick it once, pull your finger down and away. It's called a pull-off. And then that sounds the note right behind it, okay? The note I'm fretting with my second finger. And then you do the same thing there to pull off to 12, okay? And you do that in real time. And eventually, you should get some really strong sounding notes without having to pick, okay? So it's a series of little pull-offs there. So if you're brand new to pull-offs and that whole technique, that might be something that you would spend some time with alone, just trying to get the pull-offs sounding clean and rhythmically kind of even, okay? Okay? So that'll be something fun to practice. Let me put all that together for you. Okay, so you guys have fun with that. Practice up on the intro riff, and check your email real soon for the next part of this tune. You guys have fun.